the community never had a proper impression of the school. As you know, people were looking at it at the government school, you get there, you never make it. The biggest challenge was the mindset of our staffs. People were taking work for granted. I realized the school performance and was being undermined because of the lack of the effort from the teachers. Then we started building from that point. The total population of the school was 415. 215 were girls, then 200 were boys. And by the time I came here, the school was not registering passes. Passing in first grade wasn't the issue. And now as we talk, we are now 800 plus learners in the school. Here in this school, girls are more than the boys. Come back to performance, girls also are performing better than boys. Taking an example, last year we had 8 first graders. Out of the 8 first graders, 5 were girls. Luckily enough, we got the best performed girl in the government school, came from our school here. One thing, when we came, we started practicing what we call inclusive education. Here in the inclusive education, we are looking for everybody to be in the school. And the community now knows that wherever you try to play with any girl in our school, we have the police who handle us express. One of our girls was picked away. We had to engage the police. We went and got that girl from Amora and brought her back to school. And the culprit is taken in. And that is what we had agreed. You register the child in the school, the child disappears, we follow you, the parents. We have created learning centers at home of children with disabilities. And every weekend, Saturdays, we get to their home, like 2 hours engagement, and then the children from the nearby family there, they come there and they learn, children in the school. Last year, one of the child passed in Division 1 and it was a child with disability. So we have now put the school to be the home and the home to be the school. And then we identify, say, parents, you have different talents. And out of these different talents, these are what we want to make. And then we make the teachers to come up with the design of the learning aids that they want. Those parents who are talented in that, we call them. Voluntarily, they come and help. So that we make our school decorate, learning to be really and everything active. Every Friday, parents come to work in the school. So they produce the crop. When they produce the crop, we feed the children. And as a result, you can even now see P1, P2, what takes them home. There's nothing, they're just in the school, and everybody's enjoying the school.
Before Joyce came to the school was really very embarrassing. The people were very, very, very few. We were having about 200 people only in the school. There was nothing completely in the account of the PTA. We had only one block of 5 classrooms. But when it came, they added some, these 2 blocks, this one block with 2 classrooms, and they then also renovated that block there. Registration, there are very many challenges when opening the school, because you find crowd of people here. Very many children wanted to enter here.
When I joined this school, it was not nice as it is now. Things have now changed, and we have computers, everything is at school.
And using the computers are very nice because the words which you don't know is just like a dictionary. You can just find it from the computer. That is why I like. When I was in P1, we used not to eat lunch from school. We just go up to home and we come back. But the teacher delay in the class, we cannot now go back for lunch. Lunch is now, we can eat it from school.
We have started our own saving. As a staff, the circles, staff circles, teachers now no longer comes to me. They borrow money from within the pool and they pay with little interest, the interest of 2%. And that's how we are helping ourselves. You know, it's very easy to manage someone who is economically stable. We do not have the staff room. We do not have the library. We have created our staff room, our library in the classroom. We are doing what we call co-teaching. When you get to class, you find one teacher seated behind.